Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We are starting this video by taking a look at the upcoming Falcon 9 launch, which is expected in a few days. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the CRS-23 mission is scheduled to lift off on Saturday at 7:37am UTC or 3:37am EDT. Elon Musk posted a series of tweets related to Starlink, with the first announcing that 100,000 Starlink user terminals have been shipped. Then, his second tweet said, "Now serving," and then he posted the flags of 14 countries, so Starlink is now available in 14 different countries. Finally, he also tweeted, "Our license applications are pending in many more countries, hoping to serve Earth soon." There was an article posted about Starlink on the Teslarati website with information from Gwynne Shotwell. It says SpaceX COO and President Gwynne Shotwell says that the company has secured more than 500,000 pre-orders for Starlink satellite internet in the last 9 months. There was a Business Insider article posted with information from Gwynne Shotwell about liquid oxygen shortages. It says SpaceX President Gwynne Shotwell said on Tuesday that liquid oxygen shortages were making it more difficult to launch rockets and that people should email her if they have some spare. It also says it's also required in hospitals to treat patients infected with COVID-19, as well as for water treatment, and supplies are running low. Ian Atkinson posted a tweet I wanted to share. He said, "These pics are a few days old, but I passed the Roberts Road site on Friday for the KSC bus tour. No boosters visible, but the transporter was. Also, a line of cement trucks were behind Hangar X and they were pouring concrete. Seemed pretty important with the amount of trucks." Over in Boca Chica, work continues with the orbital tank farm construction. Here's a view of the base of the launch tower as work continues. Work on the launch tower quick disconnect arm is continuing. Engineers continue to also work on the launch tower's catching arms. RGV Aerial Photography posted a great photo on Twitter of how the outline looks for the new wider high bay SpaceX are planning to build. On the right, you can see the current high bay size, so this new one will be drastically bigger. Elon Musk responded to that tweet with, "Can't wait for new high bay." This new structure was recently spotted at the production site. Some new robots were spotted delivered to Boca Chica. There was an article posted saying, "With closures of Highway 4 and Boca Chica Beach becoming more frequent due to activity at SpaceX's Starbase production complex and launch site, Cameron County officials are mulling ways to restore access to at least part of the beach even during closures. One possible solution would entail building a tunnel from the south end of South Padre Island to a point on the north end of Boca Chica Beach, an idea proposed by the boring company owned by SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk." There was a picture posted on Twitter recently by somebody called Shane Overvold of SpaceX's platform called Phobos. This retired oil rig was spotted some months ago and since then has been stripped down a lot. However, in the recent Everyday Astronaut Elon Musk interview, Musk mentioned SpaceX were not thinking about these rigs at all at the moment. Work has been continuing on the new smooth nose cone in the tent. The other nose cones are continuing to be worked on also. On Monday, the small ground support equipment tank recently constructed was moved to the launch site. Here's a view of the ground support equipment tank GSE-7 stacked in the mid bay. Starship 20 is waiting for proof testing on suborbital pad B. Taking a look at the Cameron County website for upcoming road and beach closures for testing, the closure yesterday was cancelled. However, they still have a closure scheduled for today and tomorrow, hopefully for the first proof testing of Starship 20. Also, a little earlier today, they added another intermittent road closure for something to be rolled out. Super Heavy Booster 4 is still being worked on in the high bay. Some Raptor engines were spotted moved to the high bay, presumably for Booster 4 installation. To finish up today's video, we have the latest Starbase production diagram to take a look at, thanks to Brendan Lewis. Of course, I have to finish the video by saying thanks to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who is out there constantly filming the amazing content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.